see purpose of Easter? What is Easter all about? Yesterday we learned that Easter is just really a continuation of Lent. And the whole activity is to realize the importance of God's actions and ways in the life of men on earth. I would just like to pick out one portion of our readings today as point of reflection, because there are so many thoughts that we can reflect on. The evening gospel alone is filled with beautiful insights and revelations. In the book of Daniel, the king Nebuchadnezzar, who has already favored Daniel and his three friends, and his kingdom began to flourish and begin to be prolific, began to grow and become abundant. And the danger of that, in fact, even in Psalm 62, it says, when riches increase, don't set your heart on it. In 1 Timothy, it says, the love of money is the root of all evil. There is a snare, there is a trap that happens with the things of this world. We get so caught up and forget that the true essence of life is what God has done in our lives today, to acknowledge Him. And the prescription for that is so that we come every Sunday and feast upon Him, begin to lift up our hearts so that we see life from God's perspective. And this is what Daniel mentioned to the king in verse 26. And it was commanded to leave the stump with the roots of the tree. Your kingdom will be assured to you after you recognize that it is heaven that rules. It is heaven that rules. Whatever we are facing, whatever predicament, problem, anuman ang inaharap natin, may kasaganahan man, mayroong kahirapan man, mayroong pagsusubok man, mayroong kaginhawaan. Ano man ang buhay, kahit na yung ordinaryong pang-araw-araw na buhay, hindi dapat nawawala sa ating pag-iisip. It is heaven that rules. It is heaven that rules. That as heaven rules, there is a spiritual action that takes place which many are not aware. Bakit nagkakaroon ng tao na parang tatuyuan sa buhay? Bakit may mga tao parang nawawala na lang ng tiwala sa Diyos? Bakit naman may mga tao masisidin, masisigasig sa kanilang pananampalataya? Lingin sa ating isipan na sa kabila ng pisikal na mundo ito, meron mga spiritong kumikilos at gumagalaw na nag-lead sa atin, sabi nga ni St. John sa kanyang letter, 1 John 4:6, to the spirit of truth or the spirit of error? Ang spirito ng katotohanan o ang spirito ng kamalian? And the whole aspect there is that spiritual world that exists beyond this physical world that we live in. And Easter was to bring about the completion of the work of God in the spirit realm. That's why Jesus descended into the dead. The gates of Hades was broken. The spiritual force was paralyzed so that the effect of that in our lives today can be seen. That's why, even in Daniel, it says, the king saw an angelic watcher, spiritual, becoming physical. That's why in the prayer of our Lord, it says, your kingdom, O Lord, come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Why? Because it is heaven that rules. Sa kalangitan nagagaling ang lahat ng kasaysayan ng ating buhay. That's why we need to come back always to the heaven. That's why we need to be martyrs every day. Yun ang sinasabi dun sa ating prayer. That this, na tayo ay maging witnesses. That we can become witnesses. Tayo ay maging saksi o magpatotoo. A witness is one like Stephen when he was martyred that sees heaven open. And that's what we have here today. We have every day the Eucharist, an experience of Easter to see heaven open. And palalahanan tayo sa pangaraw-araw ng buhay. It is heaven that rules. Jesus said in his prayer in the Gospel, the Spirit of the Lord is now upon me. The Spirit of the Lord. He just came from the wilderness 40 days and 40 nights. Heaven was open and the Spirit of the God, like a dove, came upon him. Because even Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, recognizes it is heaven that rules. Amen.